hundreds of homes and structures this morning were completely demolished by a destructive landslide in Switzerland, with a person sadly reported as currently missing. And now, a local river is blocked for a length of 2.1 kilometers, creating the potential for further mayhem downstream. This occurred on May 28, 2025, when the imminent major landslide south-southeast of the village of Blatten involving the remaining unstable 3.5 million cubic meters of rock gave way all at once, specifically at 3:24 p.m. local time. Yet, something was immediately wrong. It appears that a significantly larger mass of rock collapsed than was expected in what had been deemed as a worst-case scenario. While yes, this is a preliminary estimate by myself and not official sources, it appears to me that at least 12.96 million cubic meters of rock, or 270% more than the deemed worst-case scenario, slid down the mountain at a speed of at least 77.6 miles per hour or 124.9 kilometers per hour. Once the mass of rock reached the valley bottom, its momentum continued pushing it forwards, running up the adjacent mountain to destroy everything within 216 meters or 709 feet above the valley floor. As this occurred, the majority of the then evacuated village of Blatten was demolished, and the Lonza River that ran through the settlement was completely blocked. In only 2 minutes' time, an area of 2.28 square kilometers or 563.4 acres had been destroyed, taking what I have geolocated as numerous cars, 334 destroyed structures, and damaging at least another 27 structures. While the cause of the specific landslide is almost certainly due to glacial retreat, permafrost thaw, or a combination thereof no longer holding up otherwise unstable slopes, the culprit is regardless that rising temperatures are to blame. This is why landslides like this are becoming more common in permafrost and recently glaciated areas worldwide, such as Switzerland, Greenland, Canada, and Alaska. But back to the current disaster. While at least $300 million in damage has already occurred, this total has the potential to further increase unless immediate precautionary methods are made by the authorities. To show you what I mean, I am zooming in to the portion of Blatten which was spared by the major landslide, with some structures only surviving car-sized boulders stopping a few meters in front of them. Note the Lonza River. This river is now completely blocked for a length of 2,100 meters downstream, and as a result, a natural dam now exists. This earthen dam is at least what I estimate to be 8 meters thick, but it wouldn't be unreasonable to guess that it is at least 20 meters thick at the lowest point of the river valley. Water is currently building behind the landslide deposits at an average rate of around 5 cubic meters per second. It will not take too long for this rising lake to begin flooding otherwise untouched structures just upstream of the blockage. Here is what would be potentially affected by a rise of 8 meters and now a rise of 20 meters. But this isn't even the last problem yet. The potential now exists, as did for this graphic I made to explain the dangers of an outburst flood from Canada's Chilcotin River landslide that happened in July of 2024. Water is an impressive erosional force and will quickly make its way through cracks and weak points in the landslide deposit. These small drainage points will slowly expand over time until it becomes large enough that it suddenly carries away large portions of blocking rock, potentially causing an outburst flood to sweep downstream. Such an outburst flood would likely carry with it portions of destroyed homes and structures, rock, along with trees and vegetation, making it quite deadly. While I do not exactly have the best resolution topographic map to go off of, I have marked a few areas that in my opinion could be at risk during a future outburst flood. I would personally recommend, as someone that has no authority in the area, that the Stasi-Furden Reservoir to the south immediately be emptied, albeit at a safe rate that doesn't flood structures downstream, in hopes that once emptied the reservoir can catch and contain the majority of whatever outburst flood might occur. I also want to note that the unstable ridge segment on the northern portion of Beechhorn Mountain which collapsed could still produce further landslides. More analysis is needed. Stay tuned for more updates and keep an eye out for official further evacuation orders if and when they are made. As a final note, I would like to thank my patron Alex Hunt for upgrading their Patreon membership tier to this channel.